Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to discuss our new chapter, demand. So let's start from demand. What is demand? Demand means desire to buy a commodity backed with sufficient purchasing power or willingness to pay at a given price at a given period of time. So what is demand? Demand means desire for a commodity, ability to buy, willingness to pay at the given price at a given period of time. Desire for a commodity. It means किसी commodity को खरीदने की इच्छा. Ability to buy. It means किसी commodity को खरीदने की योग्यता. Willingness to pay. It means commodity पे खर्च करने की तत्परता. At the given price. जो उसका price है commodity का उस price पे. At a given period of time. एक particular period of time में. तो what is the overall definition of demand? Demand means desire to buy a commodity backed with sufficient purchasing power or willingness to pay at a given price or at a given period of time. So it's a overall definition of demand. Okay, now what the function of demand for x is equal to functional relationship px, m, t, pl and pr. So what is px here? Dx means demand for good x. Demand for good x. Dx means demand for good x. It's a function. Functional relationship. Functional relationship. Or Px means price of commodity x. Okay, so if suppose that price of commodity x is increased, अगर commodity x के price increase होते हैं तो क्या होगा? Demand for good x is decreased. जो हमारी demand होगी good x के लिए वो क्या हो जाएगी? Decrease हो जाएगी. ओके और इफ प्राइस ऑफ कमोडिटी एक्स इज डिक्रीज द डिमांड इज इंक्रीज. इट मींस अगर किसी कमोडिटी के प्राइस इंक्रीज होते हैं तो उस कमोडिटी की डिमांड कम हो जाती है और इफ द प्राइस ऑफ ए कमोडिटी इज डिक्रीज द डिमांड ऑफ दैट कमोडिटी इज इंक्रीज. ओके क्लियर. सो हियर पी एक्स इज प्राइस ऑफ कमोडिटी एक्स. सो प्राइस ऑफ कमोडिटी एक्स इफ price of commodity X is increased, the demand of that commodity is decreased, and the price is decreased, the demand of that commodity is increased. Here M means money income. Okay, money income or our income. Okay, if money income is increased, अगर हमारी income increase होती है तो क्या होगा? हमारी मनी इनकम अगर इंक्रीज होती है तो हमारी डिमांड इंक्रीज होगी और इफ आवर मनी इनकम इज डिक्रीज आवर डिमांड इज डिक्रीज. इट मींस ओवरऑल इफ आवर इनकम इज इंक्रीज द डिमांड फॉर कमोडिटी इज इंक्रीज. ओके एंड इफ आवर इनकम इज डिक्रीज द डिमांड फॉर कमोडिटी इज डिक्रीज. नेक्स्ट टेस्ट. T means taste and preference. Taste and preference. Okay, so if our taste is high, अगर हमारे taste ज्यादा अच्छे हैं, ठीक है, अच्छे taste हैं, good taste हैं, गुड टेस्ट है, तब क्या होगा? डिमांड ज्यादा होगी. अगर हमारे टेस्ट बैड टेस्ट है तो डिमांड कम होगी. पॉपुलेशन. पीएल मींस पॉपुलेशन. अगर पॉपुलेशन ज्यादा है, अगर पॉपुलेशन ज्यादा है या इंक्रीज हो रही है तो इन दिस कंडीशन आवर डिमांड इज इंक्रीज्ड. और इफ population is decreased, then demand is also decreased. Okay, so dx is equal to functional relationship between px, m, t, pl and pr. Now we will discuss pr. What is pr? Price of relative goods. It's a very important concept. PR is price of related goods. It's divided into two parts. The first one is substitute goods and the second one is complementary goods. The substitute goods, everything is clear from the name of the topic, substitute goods. If the price of a commodity is increased, then the consumer refers to another related good. ठीक है? मतलब, if the price of tea is increased, the consumer shifted from tea to coffee. Okay? So, it's a substitute goods. अगर किसी कमोडिटी के प्राइस इंक्रीज होते हैं तो हम जो उससे रिलेटेड गुड्स है उस पे शिफ्ट हो जाते हैं. ठीक है, जैसे जैसे आपकी कॉफी और टी है. ठीक है, अगर इन दोनों में से किसी एक के प्राइस इंक्रीज होते हैं, द कंज्यूमर शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम अनदर गुड. ठीक है, इफ द प्राइस ऑफ टी इज इंक्रीज, देन द कंज्यूमर शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम टी टू कॉफी. दैट इज अवर सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड्स. And the second one is complementary goods. These goods are basically interdependent on each other. Okay, these goods are interdependent on each other, which complete the demand of each other. जो एक दूसरे की डिमांड को पूरी करती हैं, उन्हें हम बोलते हैं complementary goods. For example, we will take example petrol and car. Okay, if the price of petrol is increased, the demand for car is decreased. अगर प्राइस पेट्रोल के इंक्रीज होते हैं तो हमारी जो डिमांड होगी कार खरीदने के लिए वो क्या हो जाएगी, कम हो जाएगी. वो होती है हमारी कंप्लीमेंट्री गुड्स. ओके, सो अगेन डिमांड, डिमांड मींस डिजायर फॉर ए कमोडिटी बैक्ड विद सफिशिएंट परचेजिंग पावर और विलिंगनेस टू पे एट ए गिवन प्राइस एट ए गिवन पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. दैट इज अवर डिमांड. ओके, सो dx is equal to functional relationship between px, m, t, pl and pr. Price of good x, if price of good x is increased, the demand of that good is decreased. Or if price of that good decreased, the demand for that commodity is increased. Money income, agar hamari money income increase hoti hai, tab kya hota hai? If money income is increased, the demand is also increased. Or if money income is decreased, the demand is also decreased. Taste and preference. If our taste is good, if our taste is increased, the demand is also increased. Or if our taste is decreased, the demand is also decreased. Again, population. If population is increased, the demand is increased. Or if population is decreased, the demand is decreased. Okay. And last, the price of related good divided into two parts. The first one is substitute goods. Everything is clear. The name substitute goods means if the price of a commodity is increased, then the consumer shifted from another good, which are related to each other. And complementary goods, these goods are interdependent goods. Okay, like as petrol and car. Law of demand. If price of good x is increased, the demand of good x is decreased. And if price of good x is decreased, the demand of good x is increased. It's our law of demand. If price of good x is increased, the demand of good x is decreased. And the price of good x is decreased, the demand of good x is increased. Now we will discuss assumptions for law of demand. The first assumption, the income of consumer is constant. Second, price of related goods are constant. Third, taste and preference are constant. Now we will understand this law from table and diagram. Px, price of commodity X. Dx, demand for commodity X. तो जब हमारा price 10 है, ठीक है, at this point our price is 10, then our demand is very high, that is 80. And when the price is shifted from 10 to 15, our demand is decreased. At this point, when our price shifted from 10 to 15, our demand is decreased. Our demand is decreased, 80 to 50. And when price is increased 15 to 20, then our demand is decreased continuously. At this point, our demand is 10. So this is our demand curve, and OX axis we will take demand for X, and OY axis we will take price PX. The slope of demand curve is downward. So it's a law of demand. Thank you.